Hey, you. Yeah, I'm talking to you. You looking for a new car? Kind of cool, kind of rare, styled to look like that FRS sports car that you really want to buy? Check out that 2014 Scion TC over my shoulder. That thing saves $5,000 over the FRS sports car. And while it's not quite as much fun to drive as the car you really want, it's going to be cheaper to insure. If I know you, you're probably just getting into your first new job, got a salary with benefits, but you got a mountain of student debt, and maybe you're still living at mom and dad's house. You need to save every penny you can. That car's gonna help. And if you're a teenager who's lucky enough to have parents helping you buy a new car while you're still in high school, this thing is full of stuff they're gonna love. Starting with the price. It's under 20 grand, and it's loaded with equipment. So Scion restyled the TC for 2014. This is not an all new car. It's an update of the previous one, but it gets a whole new front end, new hood, new lights, new front fascia. It's all designed to look just like the FRS. LED accent lights. It's got 18-inch wheels. These are standard. Dark painted pockets with machined finished spokes. You come around to the back here. New LED brake lights. And the rear bumper is designed also to look like the FRS. Don't forget, this car comes standard with a full panoramic sunroof as well, under 20 grand. So what do you get for your 20 grand in the Scion TC? Well, you get a lot of stuff. First of all, you got air conditioning, you got cruise control, power windows with express down operation on the driver's side, that's both up and down. You got power door locks with remote keyless entry, this big panoramic sunroof that pops open to let the sunshine in. But what's really kind of impressive is this standard 6.1-inch display audio system. It's got Bluetooth connectivity, including music streaming. And if you've got an extra $1,200, you can upgrade this to Scion's bespoke system, which includes navigation and AHA connectivity to a bunch of internet radio stations, social media platforms, and all kinds of stuff. Now, one thing you don't have to worry about with this car are some of the safety nannies that come in maybe some of the other cars your parents are pitching to you. So, you know, things like curfew alerts, location sharing systems, speed governors, stereo volume limiters. I mean, all that stuff is available on other cars in this class, but this car doesn't have it. One thing this car is lacking that it should have, though, text messaging capability, hands-free. Because of that, you know, just leave your phone tucked away someplace safe and get back to your social life later, okay, please. Now, to get the car for under 20 grand, you've got to be able to shift your own gears because a 6-speed manual is standard. But the 6-speed automatic only costs an extra grand, and this year it's upgraded so that it shifts faster and includes something called dynamic rev management, and it makes the car a little more entertaining to drive. In addition to making changes to the transmission this year, Scion has also retuned the electric steering, and they've retuned the suspension. The car still comes with standard 18-inch wheels with 225/45 tires, and the car is a lot more fun to drive than it used to be before. If you've got some extra cash laying around, you can go to the Toyota Racing Development Catalog. You can get a performance exhaust system for this car, lowering springs, a front strut tie brace, and a set of sweet-looking 19-inch wheels with lower profile tires. Now, I've driven a Scion TC equipped that way, and it's really a blast. Now, it's true that there's nothing in that catalog that will actually make the car go faster, but the TC's pretty quick right out of the box, and I gotta say, I had a blast driving it. Now, it's true that the TC competes with other small cars, but that's mainly because it's small on the outside. On the inside, it's surprisingly spacious. Let's start by talking about the front seats. There's a lot of seat track travel here, and the dashboard's cut away close to the windshield, giving the front passenger plenty of knee room. These seats are sport bolstered, they're wrapped in durable fabric, they've got great thigh support, and on the driver's side, there's a seat height adjuster so that you can lift yourself higher in the car for better visibility. Now, as I've said many times, I'm not a small guy, but as you can see, this slides forward and I have no problem fitting in. And even with this seat reclined a little bit, I've got plenty of leg room, plenty of foot room. My head doesn't touch the back glass. Really, I'm amazed that four people my size can easily fit in this thing. It's got a big trunk too. Behind the rear seats, there's 14.7 cubic feet. That is about the same as a mid-size sedan. If you need more space, it's got 60-40 split folding rear seat. Scion says that you can fit a surfboard in here with those seats folded down. I'm saying, you know, maybe you could pack for your dorm room in here, maybe make a keg run, you know, whatever you need. Now listen, kid, go get your parents. I'm gonna make myself presentable, and we're gonna explain to them why they should rubber stamp your decision to get this car. Hi, Mom and Dad. I'm Chris Wardlaw with Auto Vitel, and I've been talking to your son or daughter about this car right here, the 2014 Scion TC. And because I'm a middle-aged guy wearing a tie, you can trust what I have to say. Look, in all seriousness, this is a car you should be considering for a younger member in your household. Number one, it starts at less than $20,000. That makes it super affordable. Now, I know that's not exactly cheap, but it is better equipped than most other cars in its class at the same price. Plus, this thing retains its value exceptionally well. It gets a 5-star retained value rating from ALG, and that helps push lease rates down. So if you don't want to make a monthly payment on a purchase, you can lease this car for an exceptionally low monthly payment. Plus, it's got 2 years and 25,000 miles of free scheduled maintenance, and it gets 31 miles per gallon on the highway. Let's not forget, this is all Toyota underneath. And Toyota is a company that has a long-standing record of delivering decent reliability over time. Additionally, this is a really safe car. Now, part of the reason is because it weighs over 3,000 pounds. A lot of small cars weigh less than that. The other reason is it gets a 5-star rating from the National Highway Traffic Safety Administration as an overall crash test score, and it's one of the few small cars to get a top safety pick plus rating from the Insurance Institute for Highway Safety. Now, standard equipment includes 8 airbags, anti-lock brakes with brake assist, traction and stability control, and Toyota's smart stop technology, which means the car can't accelerate as long as somebody is pushing down on the brake pedal. One thing it doesn't have is hands-free text messaging, and I can't believe Scion doesn't put that in this car. I mean, it's such an obvious feature to have for the target demographic. So you're gonna have to remind your kids once again, no texting while they're driving. Another thing that the TC lacks is Toyota's Safety Connect service. Now, the reason that I think this car should have that is because when Safety Connect is active and the airbags deploy, there's this 911 calling feature that automatically puts rescuers on the road to save whoever got into an accident. And this car doesn't have it, which I think is another important safety feature for younger drivers. Now, even though the TC lacks those safety features we just talked about, I personally would still buy this for my own kid. It might not be exactly what he or she might want, but I'll tell you what, it's better than most of the other cars at its same price point, and it offers a level of practicality that virtually guarantees that they won't need another new car until they start a family of their own.